Garfield because he wouldn't inform. He drove him from the screen and he lost his livelihood. A funeral was held on the Upper West Side. 10,000 people mourned and cried. An actor was gone at the age of 39. John Garfield of the group theater had died. Paychecks were small and the tenement halls were filled with many worried souls. They crushed John Garfield because he wouldn't inform. They drove him from the screen and he lost his livelihood. His mother passed away. Child, and up to the Bronx his father moved. He played hooky too much and got expelled from some schools, and he always seemed in a troubled mood. But then he found a friend in the middle of the rules, a man named Angelo Patrick. Patry helped him out, and he boxed and did act, and he hitchhiked across the country. They crushed John Garfield because he wouldn't inform. They drove him from the screen, and he lost his livelihood. And then the 30s came, and jobs were hard to find. And around the group theater, he hung. They taught him there his craft, and he learned some politics. And from their stage, he went to Hollywood. His screen intensity caused him to steal the scene. He soon achieved great popularity. Among his movies, they made me a criminal. Gentlemen's Agreement in Body and Soul. They crushed John Garfield because he wouldn't inform. They drove him from the screen and he lost his livelihood. Restless and felt chained by his wife, and his family still left him unfulfilled. His rise up from the depths to fame and great success makes some people nickname him Prince of Bars. His friends were on the left who worked for peace and justice. So when the Red Scare came, they got repressed. But John had signed too much to protest Wall Street's lust, and so his name got smeared by the blacklist. They crushed John Garfield because he wouldn't inform. They drove him from the screen. John Garfield, Wall Street crushed, for he symbolized resistance to their will. They crushed John Garfield because he wouldn't before.